It's 1976, and a passenger plane leaving Tel Aviv and heading to Paris has been hijacked by terrorists. It's been rerouted to Uganda to wait for negotiations to begin with the Israeli government. But Israel is not known for negotiating with terrorists. So, does 7 Days in Entebbe deliver on the intensity and drama of the real-life event? Or does this film simply feel 7 days long? Let's dive in and take a look in this review. The trailers for this film were actually very misleading, which surprisingly turned out to be a very good thing in my opinion. The trailers led me to believe that this was actually going to be a rescue action mission film. So when I sat down in my seat in the theater, I was prepared for lots of actions and daring rescue missions that may or may not work out. So the story moves through each of the 7 days, one day at a time, with an occasional jump back in time to the days before two of the German terrorists joined up with the Palestinian terrorists. These two characters were Bridget Kuhlman, played by Rosamund Pike, and Wilfred Bowes, played by Daniel Brühl, who both deliver captivating performances. Interestingly, this film doesn't really explore the rescue mission and the action and adventure part as much. What it dares to look at is the perspectives and the philosophical leanings of the German terrorists, Palestinian terrorists, the Israeli government and military officials, and even one French engineer, played by Denis Menochet. It also explores everyone's mindset as they wait at the airport each day for the Israeli government to call. So this film is really exploring a hostage situation and the human conditions. Also, socio-political and socio-economic factors that go all the way back to World War II. And then to add one more layer to this movie, there is an artistic, interpretive dance number that takes place throughout the film. Truth be told, initially it felt kind of odd because they keep coming back to the same dance number over and over, but they do explain it, and it does have value. The dance number actually symbolizes the life of the Israelis as they're trying to decide on the appropriate action to take in this situation. But we do have to wait a while to actually get this understanding of what's going on with the dancing. This pronouncement is made later towards the middle of the film when the dance choreographer is talking to the lead dancer about the dancing and how it represents life, etc. So if you miss this moment for whatever reason, if you miss this conversation, the entire dance number will seem very odd and you won't actually get the importance or the value of it as it runs again from beginning to end in this film. 7 Days in Entebbe is playing at your local movie theater right now. If you enjoy thought-provoking dramatic films that are based on real-life events and real-life stories, this is the film for you. I actually enjoyed my time in the theater, surprisingly. Again, even though this film is not what the trailers led me to believe, I really did enjoy my time watching this film, and it did not feel 7 days long. It wasn't at all what I expected, but it still delivered a thought-provoking, dramatic, and artistic story. There's very little action in this movie. The rescue mission takes place at the very end of the film. However, I do believe this film delivered the story and the message it intended to, and because of that, it's getting at least one high five from this guy. 7 Days in Entebbe is playing at your local movie theater right now. Check it out. Hi, I'm Jeremy Brunansky, and you've just finished watching a movie review on Brunansky's Vlog. Along with the movie reviews and the weekly show, we also do the Certified Rad segments and the movie news breakdown, which you may want to check out. All right, everybody, we'll see you next Monday for a brand new episode of Brunansky's Vlog, Monday morning, 10 a.m. PST. See you there. Have a great week.